I cannot believe I just realized that it's my parents' anniversary. It's their anniversary that she's just getting ready to like, you know, click pictures. I have to shoot this video and then we'll do like a small cake cutting. So anyways, hi you guys, how you doing? What's up? Welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, hi, I'm Akanksha. So in today's video, I know I'm late. There was actually I was supposed to do this video a long time ago, but there was a miscommunication with me and the brand. They were going to send me the foundation, so I waited, but they didn't. There was like a whole thing. So finally I bought it, I tried it, so I'm going to review it. We are going to talk about the Kalabar 24 hours weightless liquid foundation. I have a certain few thoughts about it, so we will see, you know, what I think. They launched 30 shades, which is incredible. So we are going to talk about everything related to this foundation. I'm going to compare the shade with the shades I have of different foundations. We're going to do a wear test. Like you can see, I have to go outside. We'll have a quick cake cutting ceremony. I'll keep it on for a few hours and then we'll see my final thoughts. We'll do everything, how it works with the product, whatever, whatever is basically there about a foundation. I don't know why I'll always end up blabbering so much. But hi, welcome to my channel. So anyways, we are going to talk about this foundation, so let's get started. Before we start, can we talk about how cute this top is? So cute. I already prepped my skin. I'm just going to use some primer now before I go in with the foundation. So for primer today, I'm using the Smashbox Vitamin Glow. I really like this primer, hydrates the skin and primes the skin at the same time. So I'm just going to take that and apply it all over. Just gives that very nice dewy feeling to the skin. You can see there's a tiny bit of hydration, but not too much, which is like the best for oily skin. I don't like too mattifying primers or too shiny primers, so this is like the perfect balance. Anyways, we're not here for the primer. This is the Kalabar liquid weightless foundation. It's a tube, but once you open, you do have a pump. I hate foundations which come without a pump. So this is ₹9.95. yes, it's not cheap. ₹9.95 is a lot for a drugstore foundation. I think they didn't want to touch the 1000 mark because it'd be like 1000 rupees. They were like, you know, let's reduce ₹5 and make it look like a foundation under $1000. And you get 25 ml product in this, which is like okay, but usually most of the foundations you get 30 ml of product. For decent one, the K-Beauty one which I tried, this ₹1200, we get 30 grams of product in this. Then the Maybelline Fit Me is like 550 or something, and you get 30 ml of product. So you know, just mentioning that this is 25 ml and this is $9.95. so I have the shade 6.2, so I'm going to compare the shade with the my other foundation shade references, just so you understand where you stand in case you want to purchase and want a shade reference. So this is Kalabar 6.2. So this is a very proper yellow toned, you know, shade. You can see there's a lot of yellow there. Then this is my Maybelline Fit Me in 310. Maybelline Fit Me 310 is a very neutral shade. That's the reason it looks very like plain beside it, because the Kalabar one you can see is very, very yellow. This is my MAC NC40. So it kind of matches NC40 a lot. NC40 is also quite yellow. So, you know, both of these match perfectly. Just the 6.2 is a tad bit darker, but works pretty fine. Then I'm swatching the Fenty in 300. Fenty Beauty in 300. So you understand, right? Like, it's quite a close match. I picked the right shade. I just did such a guesswork. I was like, I hope it matches me. I think it's a bit lighter, but I think once I blend it out, you guys don't like, you know, you not make a difference that it's light or darker to my skin. So these are the shade references. This is the Kalabar 6.2, this is the MAC NC40, This is the Maybelline 310 Fit Me and this is the Fenty 300. Just going to reapply my primer a little bit more. So on the right side we are going to use a sponge and on the left side we are going to use a brush. Now I did try this foundation before and I do have my thoughts, like I said. So the first thing, which was a very big turn off for me. So the first thing which is a very big turn off for me with this foundation is the fragrance it has. I do not like, it's the, not even the factor that it has fragrance, but the factor, I don't know, it gives me a very cheap feeling for some reason. Like it's $9.95, you guys. Like least I think we could expect is it to be fragrance free. At least if it has fragrance for it to, you know, smell a little better. It gives me that Pond's Pins powder kind of like feeling and I don't like that. So on the right side, dotting the same thing. So the foundation, as you can see, is quite thick. It's not a runny formula. It's very, very thick. It's more like a mousse. If you know the texture of how moussey foundations are. So I'm going in with the sponge on the right side and I'm going to slowly take my time to blend it out. And on the left side, I'm going in with this Real Techniques buffing brush. So by the way, if you want a reference of how this one smells, if you've ever smelled Lakme CC creams, the older ones, and even right now, I think I really don't like those CC creams, especially because I don't have the right shade in them. But the CC creams one, literally like the smell is so similar to it and I hate the fragrance of it and I hate the fragrance of this one as well. So anyways, the foundation is on. I don't know why it was so bright all this time, but it is on. So right side I have a sponge, left side I have a brush. It does work with both of them really like normally, but just because people wonder, I kind of do this. But most of the foundations work well with a sponge and a brush now. But we have one layer on my face. You can see it's not a dewy foundation, it's kind of proper demi matte. It's not extremely matte as well, which is a really nice thing. It does not make you feel dry or anything. So it's that perfect balance of how I like a foundation to be. But now one layer is on, and for the consistency of the foundation, like it is thick, okay? So when you see such a foundation and you see the texture of this, you would think like it will be full coverage and it gives you like proper, like covers everything up, gives you a very flawless finish, but that is not the case. So like you can see, I have a lot of blemishes peeking through, like, and I did apply a very generous amount. Like you saw, I applied a lot more than I normally do because I know this was not going to cover. So on the left side specifically, you can see more blemishes. So it's not like a full coverage foundation. I would say it's like medium coverage, and if you go ahead and build it up. So I'm just going in with a sponge now that we've anyways tried to blend it with both. If I'm using this foundation and I have to cover my blemishes, I do have to go in with a second layer because it does not like give me the coverage, enough coverage the first time, of course. But if you have normal blemish free skin, then you would not have this problem. It's not one of those foundation which grabs onto different parts and does not like blend easily. It does blend quite easily and quite well. So like I said, this is a medium coverage foundation, but it is buildable. Now my blemishes are sort of covered up. I used completely 3 pumps of foundation. There's a little bit left on my hand, but this is how my face looks. Zoomed you guys in to see how it actually looks. So this is how it looks up close. The shade is quite a good match for my skin and the finish is nice. It blends beautifully as well. So I'm just going to finish the rest of my makeup and then we'll do a wear test also. Like I did wear this foundation before, so I know how it wears throughout the day, but I'm going to show you guys also how it wears and looks after a few hours, and then I'm going to give you my final thoughts about this. Okay, that took a lot of time. I got done doing my makeup. My parents were rushing me to come outside to click pictures, to cut the cake. And then I had to film one more video. And now it is 12 o'clock. Can you see the time? So I did my entire face of makeup, and you can see that it did wear beautifully with other products as well. I've used the products which I always use, just so that there is nothing messing around. So you can see the foundation did not get oily at all, even after 5 hours of wear, which is incredible. But that also means that if you wear a more oil control primer under this, it might make your skin feel a little more drier. I went in with the Smashbox one, which is a hydrating one, which gives a little dewy effect to the skin, and even with that primer I did not get oily at all, or my foundation did not look dewy also in any sort. So beware, if you are going to use like an extreme oil control or mattifying primer, it might be a little too much with this foundation, because already the foundation is into that matte range. And I did use a sponge also. Sometimes when you use sponge with a few products, it makes it a little more dewy, because the wetness of the sponge kind of helps diffuse it and kind of looks a little more dewy. But with this foundation, that also did not happen. Brush or sponge, it looked really similar. So if you're dry skin, then probably use a hydrating primer and then go with this one. If you're normal oily skin, just use a pore filling primer. You can go with this and it look flawless. Hi you guys, okay, it's me editing, but there's some point I forgot to mention which I think is important, so that's the reason I thought I'll add this small clip here. So I did say that if you're dry skin, you should use a hydrating primer before you go in with this foundation, right? That is true, it does work. But if you're dry skin and if you're looking for a hydrating dewy formula, then I recently reviewed the K-Beauty hydrating foundation. I'll leave a link here, you can check it out, and that one is really good for dry skin. So I think this foundation is really good for normal combination oily skin, and the K-Beauty one is really nice for dry and normal skin. But of course, the K-Beauty one, the coverage is not as much as the Colourbar one, but it is very hydrating. So you can pick and choose what is the preference you have in a foundation. And I just, wanted to put that out there, that you have two different options of two different finishes. Whichever you want, you can go for it. Okay, now back to the normal video. So this held up really beautifully, you guys. It did not crease, it did not, like, I even had dinner, my lipstick is gone for that reason. So I've had dinner, I've done a lot of things in 5 hours, and it held up really well. I even changed clothes and it did not budge this side of the garment. I just pulled it off and it just rubbed on my face, but still the foundation is holding up. So it is a really good finish. The finish is really beautiful. The way it blends into the skin is beautiful. It did not crease anywhere, it did not collect or gather anywhere. I usually gather, the foundation gathers around the nose for me, and it did not do that. So these are my final thoughts about the foundation. Is one thing which I really don't like about this is the fragrance. I really wish they get rid of the fragrance. We don't need fragrance in our skincare anyway, so I don't like to prefer makeup also which has fragrance. I tend to stay away, but sometimes with like little bit here and there, it's fine. But this one, the smell is so overpowering and it is not pleasant at all. And for the thickness of it, I would expect a little more coverage from it, but the finish is really beautiful, so I have no complaints. It's a very thick, moussey type of foundation, but gives a very beautiful finish on the skin. So one thing I would definitely recommend is go in with a pore filling primer, so that you fill your pores and the foundation looks a lot more flawless on the pore area. Like, I have not applied a pore filling primer because I wanted you guys to actually see also how it looks without a pore filling primer, and it's not bad, but it would look a lot better with a pore filling primer, if you know what I mean. So finally, an Indian brand launched 30 different shades. K-Beauty also just launched 20 shades. I mean, it's a very decent shade range for 20 shades, but still 30 shades gives a wider option to a lot more other people as well. Of course, it's a little pricey foundation, I would definitely say that, but if you don't find your shade in any of the other foundations, then you can definitely go for this one. Now, I would not say this is that foundation which looks like skin-like or natural or anything of that sort. This is a foundation which looks like foundation, but in a very nice way. It is decent, it blends into your skin really beautifully. Like, at the end of the day, unless it's a skin tint or a sheer coverage foundation, foundation is always going to look like foundation, and this is that one which looks very beautiful on the skin. This one, the finish is medium to coverage, but it is buildable. But if you have extreme discoloration, of course you have to color correct, because it does not have so much coverage where it could color correct your entire discoloration coloration. So yeah guys, those are my thoughts about the Kalaba foundation. I would give this a solid 8 out of 10. It's a very beautiful foundation. Of course, 995 is a little pricey for a drugstore foundation, but if you can invest and if you have a right shade, then you know, go for it. It's actually really nice. I don't know why I had this feeling that I'm not going to like this foundation when I bought it, and even when I was first using it, I was like, I'm not going to like it anyway. The finish is not going to be good, the coverage is not going to be good, it would not last for really long, it would cling on to things. I had every bad thought in my mind about this foundation, but it surprised me in all aspects. Quite impressed, except for that fragrance. The only reason why I would not be reaching to it as much would be that fragrance. So if you have sensitive skin, then do not buy this. It has a shit ton of fragrance. It might not suit your skin, but if fragrance is not an issue for you, then go for this one. It gives a very beautiful finish. So I'll leave a link to the product in the description if you do want to check it out. And that's it for this video. If you like the video and if you enjoyed it and if this review helped it, then make sure like and subscribe to my channel and ring the notification bell. It would mean the absolute world to me, okay? And I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye. I cannot believe I just realized that I put Bindi in the entire video. I was in another outfit doing another video in which I had Bindi, because I wore that outfit for my parents' anniversary, but I forgot to remove the Bindi on the western outfit. That Bindi did not look good. I was like, there is something off, I don't know why I'm looking off. And now I realized I had Bindi on this whole time. Why God? Why? Why?